Pens, man, they took care of business this week, man. Beat the Boston Bruins, moved into first place in the Mass Mutual East Division, which was huge, man. That was their fourth straight win. 7 regular season games left. So this is the exciting part about them, because we said with the condensed season, all the games matter, right? And this is another situation where, man, if they close this thing out the right way, they'll get this nice one seed in terms of coming out of their division. That can help them out a ton, man.
Which is crazy.
Yeah.
Because we were really concerned at the beginning of the season.
Oh, without a doubt, yes.
They've really come on strong, especially with the injuries. I can't even say his name.
Get it out now. It's because you got that big Ben beard just all in your mouth right here, man.
Malkin. He's been out, but
yeah.
To get the one seed throughout this stretch, I know our schedule's been easier, but our schedule was harder early on. That's why we didn't have as good of a time early on. But everything's coming together. I think the goaltending's playing good. But I really liked yesterday's win because it was a defensive game. Jari's first shutout. We haven't seen that. We've seen some dominant performances by the offense, but then we also see a goal or two skirt in, and we're like, man, I just would like to put together a full, clean game.
Just one normal game.
And especially against the Devils. They suck. I mean, we swept the series, but the one game, we won 7-6.
They scored six goals in the third period?
Yeah.
It was going great. I remember this. I turned the game off in the second because I was like, yo, it's over. Me and wifey were just like, yo, it's done, man. Like, we blew them out. It was what was it, 5-0? Was it 5-0 or 5-1 or something like
6-0,
I think. At the beginning of it. So it was like, man, this game's done. And then we go on social media, we're like, oh, everybody's going crazy. I'm like, oh, God, what is this?
Yeah, nuts, man.
So, yeah, that game, they won the second one 5-1, so that was more of a blowout. But the other one, they won 4-2. Mm-hmm. Honestly, that should have been 3-3 going into overtime because the Devils missed out on a really good opportunity right at the end of the game, and we got kind of like a lucky empty net. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you could say lucky because Crosby was the one shooting it. I'm kind of over that.
Lucky if it's Crosby. I think that's how it is, dude.
Just because I see some of these passes, and I'll make comments because you know I do those reactions. I'm like, oh man, this was lucky as hell. Like, there's no way Crosby meant to do that. They come back at me. They're like, dude, you're doubting Crosby. Yeah,
Crosby, he's gifted, man.
So yeah, that game should have been 3-3. But then just to get this win, I saw some stuff from the offense still that you're like, all right, this is how good the Penguins offense is. True. This is how it always is. We just didn't get the 2 or 3 goals.
Right.
They had the opportunities. And then Boston, they had a few chances, but Jari stepped up. The defense stepped up. I saw some really good plays from them. So, yeah, I'm excited.
Yeah. To me, man, I like this win because it was a playoff-style win. Sure. Anytime you get these single, you know, 1-0, 2-1 type low-scoring games, that's what playoff hockey is going to be. And the thing that I liked about Jari, even though this was his first shutout, I like the fact that this is two back-to-back dominant performances. 61 saves, or 61 saves in two games. And you just think about what he's been able to do in terms of both of those. And this is on the heels of that game where he was talking about against the Devils, where he gave up, you know, the 6 goals right at the end of that thing. So to see him mentally bounce, I mean,
that was funny too. One of the goals, like, he was trying to like score an empty net goal. You're like, come on, what are you doing, bro?
So to me, I'm just like, it's good to see that he's mentally, you know, able to recover from that, because with these guys, a lot of times we say it's mental. So it was good to see that. But the defense as a whole, I thought, has been playing better, just in better positions. Mm-hmm. Not like how we saw early on where it was the goalies having to just be crazy because our defense was so flawed. Right now, we're just playing really good hockey, getting healthy at the right time as well. It's going to be interesting to see, though, when Malkin comes back, where do you put him back go in terms of the lineups? Mm-hmm. Do you put him back on the top line, or do you put him on that second? Like, where do you want him at? Because right now, they're kind of hot.
I like Jeff Carter, dude.
I do too.
He's really good.
I do too. But the thing is, this is Malkin we're talking about. So do you go hot hand, or are you going off of what this guy has done and what he's meant for your organization? Because to me, that's the part that's getting a little dicey here, because they have a groove going right now. And do you really want to mess that groove up this close to the postseason?
That's a fair point. No. Now, whenever you say top line, because Crosby is top line, you mean the top two lines.
Yes, top two
Malkin on the second line, then you bump Carter down to the third.
And then obviously on the power play as well.
Man, that's a tough call.
It is. It
because you want Malkin
it.
On the second line when you need a playoff game and things are getting really tight. You know, you have you're in the semifinals, whatever. Right. Malkin on the second line. But I don't think it's the worst idea to ease him in maybe on that third line a little bit.
Well, and
but it's, it's one of those things, though. It's just Malkin. I don't give a crap. Like, just put him on the second line.
But
Carter is playing good for us, though.
So you see the dilemma. It's exactly. Like, do you go with the person that's hot, or do you go with the guy that's been there before, that's been proven, that we all have that emotional equity with, right? Because we've seen Malkin do this how many times? We know when he gets hot what he can be. But like you said, man, and he's been gone for a while too. And that's my other concern. It's like, when is he going to come back?
We have less than 10 games, right?
We have like 5 games left right now. Single digits. Yeah, it's 5 games left. So when I think of that, or excuse me, 7 games left. I said, yeah, 7 games left. So it's not a lot of games left for him to even get back going and get up to speed. So
yeah, like now would have been the perfect time for him to come back.
Right. I feel like if it's not within these next 2 games, like out of there, I'm just kind of like, that's 5 or 4 games. It's not a lot of time for me personally. But this is Malkin, and that's the part, right? I feel like if it's any other person, it's an easier decision. You just go with the guy that's hot. But because of who he is, yeah.
And I guess you're thinking maybe first-round matchup will be a little easier, but I don't know.
No, not I don't this know how year. It's
– yeah, exactly.
This year, you're probably going to – you might face this Boston team realistically.
Yeah. Yeah, like, you they're the 4 seed. Yeah. You have the Islanders there at the 3.
Yeah.
I don't know. Do you know how it stacks up? Like, are we going to be playing the 1 seed, playing like the 4 seed in one of these other divisions?
No, from my understanding, I thought first round of the playoffs, you're going to play within your division. So the 1 is going to play the right. So that's why it's like, if you're the 4, you're playing the Bruins. I mean, the Bruins will be playing us. And that's how it's going to be for the first round. Then after that, that's when it goes back into how they want to do the seed. And if, all right, this division versus that division and stuff. But yeah, so that's why it's like, even more intriguing. And that's the crazy part about the point system, because the Bruins are 7 points behind the Pens, right? And obviously the Pens are in first, but we don't feel like that's a gimme matchup.
No, not at all.
I mean, we feel like, yo, that can go either way. I mean, it's going to be tough, and we're going to have to play our, you know,
so really good hockey. So if we lose that game against the Bruins yesterday, we have 65 points. They would have 62.
Yeah, and then the Caps.
I mean, you're right. Yeah. That's no gimme then.
Right.
Because it's 67-60 now, but
– yeah.
Yeah, it's a perfect point right there, man. I don't want to be messing around.
Not at all, man.
I don't consider that messing around, though, just putting Malkin on the top 2 line. Carter's talented, too. Like, he's you talk about, like, pedigree, whatever it is. Like, he's got a couple cups. He's always been – he's just older now. That's what it is.
Was he 36, right?
It feels like he's getting this resurgence with the Penguins.
Well, you know that's what happens when you get around highly talented players, man. It boosts you up a little bit.
Sure. I don't know. I'm going to defer to Malkin. I would just put him in. Yeah. And then maybe 1 game it's not looking too good, then you just make the switch. Yeah. If it's game 2 in the series or game 3.
Like I said, part of me,
that might motivate
I definitely
Malkin.
Agree. But at the same time, I'm just kind of like, dang, I do like the hot. I like this hotness, but it's Malkin. And that's where I'm still just torn. But this is why we don't get paid to make those decisions. This is why Coach Sullivan, yeah, I'm going to trust your judgment on this, but make sure you make a good decision. Pretty please. Pretty please.
His timeline? It's got to be soon. They've been talking about this for a couple weeks.
Right. I mean, I felt like a week ago they were telling me that, hey, man, it's day-to-day. And then the week before that, oh, it's day-to-day. Do you still know exactly what the injury was, though?
I have no clue.
Exactly. And we talked about that. Remember, was this 4 weeks ago when it first came out? We was like,
yeah, it came after that hit.
Yeah, we were like, man, if we could just know, this could change a lot of how we view them. Now, granted, it worked out where they rose their play, but if we knew back then that he would be gone this long, I think our mentality would have been a little bit different in terms of the Penn success. But they've been able to rise and ultimately pick up the slack in his absence. But as a whole, that thing is, yeah, I would like him back, though.
Either way. I think the Pens have been impressive over these past few months just to get to this 1 seed.
Mm-hmm.
You could point out some flaws, but I think every team in the NHL, you're going to have some flaws. Yes. You're going to give up some good opportunities. We're in first place in this tough division, so hats off to the Penguins for sure.
Absolutely. And shout out to Sid the Kid too, man. With his assist on the Jake Guentzel goal at the third, that ultimately gave him his 16th season of having a point per game average. Puts him third on the list behind Wayne Gretzky, who did it for 19 seasons, and Gordie Howe, who did it for 17 seasons.
Damn.
So big time right there for Sid, man. Big time tip of the cap to the captain, our captain, Sid the Kid.
That's a good gauge too, because you see with some of those dudes like Gretzky, like Lemieux, Jager back in his prime.
Lemieux was, I think, 4th on the list.
These dudes are putting up like 200 points in a season and stuff, whereas now it's just a different era now. You're not really seeing that. I know McDavid's just been crazy. Like, a couple of those top guys just put up crazy numbers and crazy stats, but not to the extent of Gretzky. So if you could get some type of metrics like that where Crosby's still in the top 3 as some type of point-per-game basis, and then he's in that category with Gretzky and that – who'd you say? Was it Gordie Howard?
Gordie Howard. Okay. And, yep. And yeah, then, like I said, Mario Lemieux is sitting at 4 on that list.
Okay, so. Yeah. So that's just a good gauge, though, because if you just look straight points for Crosby, mm-hmm. he's not going to have the same amount that, like, Lemieux, true. Gretzky, and some of those dudes right. back in the day had. But a lot of people do consider him, you know, top 3, 4, 5 all time.
Very true, man.